Good afternoon. Let us have the clarification of your queries. Somebody was asking how to solve this fifth question of yesterday's assignment that was based upon your middle term splitting. So this was the fifth question of your assignment yesterday. I will come back to my first step. As I said, that was only the different thing I used in this fifth question. Otherwise, whatever the questions I have given to you, from middle term splitting point of view, everywhere the coefficient of x square was 1. Here it is 6. So my advice to you was, you need to find the product of this coefficient of x square and the constant term, and that here is 12. So you have to go for the prime factor of 12 such that their addition or subtraction is 13. So here 12 ones are 12, I can split. Otherwise, 6 into 2, that again will make somewhere the pair 12 or 1, yeah, that you can try. So 12 and 1, both will be carrying the positive sign. 6x square plus 12x plus x plus 2. So that was only the difference. So if any coefficient is there, that coefficient you have to multiply with the constant term. Go for the factorization, select a pair which either sums is equal to or difference. So here sum of 12 and 1 will be giving me the middle term. Both will be carrying the positive sign. Make the pair, first 2 and last 2. So here it is 6x, so x plus 2. Then in last 2, if nothing is common, you can take 1 common all the time. Again, I am coming back to you with my same instruction. Whatever will be there in the first bracket, same always will be there in the second bracket. Now overall you can take x plus 2 common, and from here it is 6x, and from here it is 1, and this is the solution for your this problem. And if you will multiply these two, that is binomial with binomial, again you will be back to this. That will be the verification for this. I hope that is clear. The another query, how to solve your exercise 9.4, question number 3 and part number 4. So exercise 9.4, question number 3, part number 4. So here is the fourth part of your this exercise, that is AB into question 3, part number 4, and exercise is 9.3. AB x square plus y square, then it is plus xy, again it is x square plus y square, and this you need to divide by x square plus y square. So this is the question, AB into x square plus y square plus xy into x square plus y square, and you need to divide it by x square plus y square. Good question again, I appreciate. If you are finding anything difficult, please feel free to clarify the doubts. So now here you see this. This is a binomial, means there are two terms. One is this, another is this. If you see from the factorization point of view, x square plus y square is the part of this product somewhere. And again, x square plus y square is the part of this product, which I can take common finally. So you take this common, then from here, you will be left with AB. And from here, you will be left with xy only. So what I did in these two terms, that is 1, 2, I have taken x square plus y square common. Whenever you are taking something common, means you have to divide it by x square plus y square and also by x square plus y square. So when you will divide it by x square plus y square, you will be left with ab only. And when you will divide whole of this term by x square plus y square, you will be leaving xy only. And whole you need to divide by what? X square plus y square. So that you can cancel here, x square plus y square. And finally, you will be having the answer AB plus xy. AB plus xy will be the answer for this. So that is the solution for your third question, part number 4. Another query is how to solve question number 6, 7 and 8 of your exercise 5.2, which I will take at last today. Before that, I will like to start with your exercise 9.5, that is your factorization. And then I will go back to this question number 6, 7 and 8. So only one part I will take, because all these three questions are based upon of reading of pie chart. So you need to pay attention. Already I have given 3-4 lectures based upon this reading of pie chart and drawing of pie chart. So whomsoever queries this, kindly go through those lectures again. No doubt I will take any one of the question today also, and I will take another question tomorrow also. You keep on sending the comments that whether are you clear with this or not. So at least one part, how to read the pie chart, because all these three questions are based upon that concept only, ki how to read the pie chart. So I'll make it clear to you at last of my today's lecture. Before that, I will like to take you to your exercise 9.5, which is based upon your factorization. So you please make a note of these types of factorization also, as we are starting today. So there are 10 types. Up to class 10 you will be studying, and I hope that up to this class 6, 7 or 8 are already we have cleared. So in these first two questions of exercise 9.5, very simple type of factorization is introduced to you. That is, if find a common factor in the given terms, like first part of first question I am taking, 15y, 30. Now we are very clear with the number of terms, 15y and 30. These are the terms, no? So in terms, I have to simply answer here, what is the common thing there? So if any variable, now we are very much clear, what are the variables, what are the coefficients? So here, y is here only, y is not there in the second, so it cannot be the common thing. Then in 15 and 30, what is common? So you find the HCF of 15 and 30, so your answer will be coming is 15. So there, factor, what is common? Common is only 15. If you are speaking from the coefficient point of view, please keep a watch. If there are more than one, like here two are there, 15 and 30, and you know both are falling in the table of 30. Or in other ways, I am saying, please find the HCF, those numbers. Whatever the HCF, you know, full form of HCF is what? Highest common factor. So that is the topic, factorization. So this is the simplest type of factorization. If the terms are given and out of those terms I want to find the common, so I like variables I am not finding common, so no need to write that. If number, so from number point of view, please keep on finding the HCF, and HCF only will be the highest common factor. Like second part now, this is second part. In second part, if you see 22a is there is the first term, and 11ab is the second term, 11ab. Now, from the variable point of view, I am very much clear that A is common there. B is not here. B is here only. So, B cannot be the common. Then, in 11 and 22, if you find the HCF, so your answer will be coming 11A. Please make these things very clear. You need to devote quality time here in these questions, so that in coming classes, you should not face any difficulty. So please make it very clear. So here A is there, which is common in both the terms, will be the common, there will be the factor. And in 11 and 22, HCF is 11, so 11A will be the common factor for these two. Now suppose I am taking the third part here. So what is the third part is? In third part, it is 14AB. In third part, first term is 14AB and second is 35A² B² Very interesting question, back to back question I am taking, and very interesting are they. So in 14 and 35, you all are clear, HCF will be 7. So answer from the numbers point of view will be 7, because the HCF of 14 and 35 will be 7. Now in this, A is there, A is also there, B is there and B is also there. But whenever you are counting the degrees, and from the highest common factor point of view, your degrees will be always counted the smaller ones, that is of degree 1, A and B, not A square and B square. Because in A square, A is the part. In B square, B is the part. In A, I just cannot count A square is the part. So lowest degree will always be the part of your answer of the variable. Suppose if anybody is asking in X, एक्स स्क्वायर और एक्स क्यूब, व्हाट इज कॉमन? सो आंसर विल बी एक्स, नॉट एक्स स्क्वायर, नॉट एक्स क्यूब. लीस्ट डिग्री, इफ इट इज सपोज वाई रेज टू पावर 7, वाई रेज टू पावर 14 और वाई रेज टू पावर 30, सो योर लीस्ट डिग्री इज वाई रेज टू पावर 7, आई कैन टेक कॉमन हेयर. सो दैट इज द पॉइंट, यू हैव टू मेक ए नोट ऑफ दैट डिग्रीज व्हेन यू आर टेकिंग. सो लीस्ट डिग्रीज विल बी द पार्ट ऑफ योर आंसर, दैट इज द फैक्टर. देन here it is fourth part, 3x, 4x square and 5, 3x, 4x square and 5. So here the HCF is 1. Very interesting, very interesting. You see why? Because in 3, 4 and 5 nothing is common, totally 3 are the different numbers. You find the HCF, that will always be equal to 1. X is there, x is here, but x is not here. In all three terms I just cannot, I have to take the factor with respect to 3 at a time with respect to 3. I just cannot take these two first and then this is third. Out of these three terms, which is the factor, that will be only and only 1, because HCF of 3, 4 and 5 will be 1. X is here, but x is not there. So at a time in three terms, only and only the one number is common, that is 1. So please make a note of that also. And then let us go to fifth part. This is very important to discuss or to share all the answers with you, because questions, back-to-back questions are varying. So instructions are very important, which I am giving to you. So please make a note of that. Next is 15a raised to the power 5, then comma minus 5a cube, and comma third one is there, 30a only. Now here the sign is also given. You please remember, students, sign. Suppose if this is carrying minus, this is also minus and this is also minus, then you can take the sign. Okay, minus is everywhere, so minus sign is common. Otherwise leave it. Now if you will take 5, 15 and 30, so I assure you the HCF will be equal to 5. HCF will be equal to 5. Find that. Do not count the sign now. 5, 15 and 30, all are the multiple of 5. So highest common factor in 5, 15 and 30 will be 5. As per your variable, a5 is here, a cube here. So what I told, a5, a cube and a. Now you count the degrees. The least degree you are finding is a out of these three. Where no degrees there, that is always 1. So your answer will be 5a. So whenever you are taking the number or any term or any variable common from the powers point of view, the least power will be the part of your answer. So in 5, 3 and 1, the least power is 1. So answer will be of the least power, that is A. So 5 from the numbers and A from the variables. Similarly, in your last part, that is 6th part, is it is 9AB, 18BC, and then it is 36AC. Now you see A is here, A is not there. So A cannot be common. B is here, but B is not there. So again it cannot be common. Now C is here, but C is not here. So out of A, B, C, nothing is common, because A, B, C commonly is not the part of all these three terms, whatever are given to me. And from 9, 18 and 36, highest common factor, all are falling in the table of 9. So your answer will be 9 for this. So please do practice of these 6 parts. Be careful. These are all the basic concept or basic ideas I am sharing with you to learn the simplest type of factorization, how to take the terms or the variables common out of the given terms. So please pay attention. In next, it is with the sign. There are 9 parts. You try it, question number 2. Otherwise, you need to follow the same instruction what I shared with you in question number 1. Otherwise, I will come back to you with the same. That is your this part of these 9 parts of question number 2 tomorrow. Now, I will go for the last query. That was how to read the pie chart. So, I am taking question number 6 today. Please pay attention. Whose query was this? Again, question number 6 in 5.2 is, this is the pie chart given to you. somewhere, that is divided into 1, 2, 3, 4 sectors are there. 4 sectors are there. This is of 120 degree. Then it is of 42 degree here. Then third sector is of 84 degree. And fifth sector is consisting of your 105 degree. And the items you are taking here is food. Here it is rent. Then it is education is here. And others are there in this fourth sector. So the following pie chart shows the monthly expenditure of a family on various items. If total expenditure, total, please make a note of the information whatever is given to you. Total expenditure given is equal to ₹12,000. Make a note of that. And answer the following. How much amount is spent on rent? How much amount? Amount spent on rent I need to calculate. So that is the part of my question, and I have to read it from the pie chart. So I will come back to that basic instruction I have given to you, how to read the pie chart, how to read the pie chart or how to draw the pie chart. Both are based upon one and one thing only. That is the key idea. What is that? Angle at the center. Angle at the center. Center, I hope you understand. This is the center of the circle here, and these are the angles which we are getting at the center, is always equal to value of the single item out of the total value. Single item means there are 1, 2, 3, 4 items. Out of 4, when I am talking about one particular item, that is called a single item. Upon the total value for these all, total, whatever the question is, like here it is depending upon the expenditure, and the total expenditure is given to you. So that is the total value. And always you need to multiply it by 360. So that is the unique formula I have to use. Whether you are going to read the pie chart or you are going to draw the pie chart, please make a note of this. So feel free to clarify the doubts. Feel free to have the queries. I will explain it 10 times to you. But my request to you, please adhere to the instructions I have given to you. You can go through the previous lectures also. Already the links I have provided to you. And today again I am coming to you with the same instruction. And please sit and devote the quality time. Somebody is asking you, give me the solution of 6, 7, 8. So I will not be giving you the solution of all three today. No doubt, if you are not finding how to apply the same idea, whatever I am sharing with you in question number 7, you come back again tomorrow. That, sir, I did not get 7. You please solve that also. Definitely, I will solve that to you. Now, this question is, what is the amount spent on rent? Now, this is the information I have to fill from this pie chart. Angle at the center. For which part you are looking for? Rent. So, go back to your pie chart. See for rent what is the angle given. And you will be finding is equal to 42. That particular item you have to select as per the question. So, angle at the center in case of rent is equal to 42 degrees. So, you write that 42. Value of the single item means that I need to calculate. You let that is equal to x. I have to calculate okay, what was the amount spent on rent. So let that is equal to x. Out of total expenditure, that is 12,000 into what? 360. That's all. Now, whatever you can do is here, this is done. 12 hundreds are and 12 threes are. So what you are getting is 42 is equal to 3x upon 100. 3x upon 100. So you do the cross multiplication here. By cross multiplication, 42 into 100. This will go to this side and 3 will come in the denominator, and that is equal to x. You can go for the cancellation. 14 into 100. So therefore x you are getting is equal to 1400. And what was x? X I assumed is the amount spent on rent that I've substituted here. So your answer will be amount spent on rent was rupees 1400. So that was your first part. And in second part now, this is asked how much amount is spent on education. So how much amount spent on education? Now you go for education. Second, same procedure you need to follow that. And suppose I am saying is y. So if it is y, look at this. Go back to this particular sector of education. Here it is education, and now here the angle is 84. So you change that. For education it is 84. Now I need to calculate the amount y. Total will remain same, that is 12,000. And here it is again 360. So if you go for the cancellation, again 3s are and 100s are. Again you go for the cross multiplication. 84 into 100 upon 3 is equal to y. And do this calculation. And that comes is equal to 2800. Y is equal to 2800 means rupees 2800 were spent on education. So then that way you can calculate the amount spent on education. And third part is, what is the ratio expressed on food and education? So now you remember, your education is coming 2800. And on food again, on food is here. That is 120 degrees. So if I will apply the same condition for food, suppose I am taking the amount spent on food is equal to Z. So what happens? In food, the angle is 120 degrees. And I calculate the amount spent on food out of total 12,000 into 360. Again, you see here, it is 1200. And again, I'm getting 3 upon 100. So 120 into 100 upon this is 3 is equal to Z. So do the cancellation here. 40s are. So this is 4000. So 4000 is the amount spent on food. And amount spent on education was what? 2800. So the ratio you can calculate in 2800 that is asked here. Express what is the ratio expressed on food and education. So food and education means food upon education ratio. So what is the food you are saying is 4000. Please check your calculations, and amount here is 2800. Two zeros are gone, four tens are and four sevens are. So 10 ratio 7 will be the amount spent on food and education. So in that way you can have the answer of all the three parts. Similarly, you can proceed in your question number 7 as well as in question number 8. Still, if you are not getting, most welcome, come back to me through your comment. Definitely I will be sharing you the solution of question 7 as well as question 8. But remember, this and this only is the key idea, either to read or to draw. Please devote quality time, because this definitely will be the part of your question paper, either to read or to draw. So 3 marks means something. So pay attention to that, and still the queries are there. You are most welcome. Thank you.